praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. So we started this series last week Sunday, titled The Power of the Tower. For the American we say, Americans we call it the power of the tower. But this we call the power of the tower. Part two, the power of servanthood. Positioning yourself, engaging yourself for greatness. So in this series, we want to develop a formula for greatness. How can we be great? This is what this is all about. Our main text is taken from John chapter 13, from verse 1 to 17. John chapter 13, from verse 1 to 17. I want to go straight to part 2. What is promotion? This message is geared towards developing ourselves for promotion. The power of the tower. How can I be promoted? How can I be great? This is what this message is all about. Either you are a Christian or you are not a Christian, everybody has a desire to be great. In any profession, you engage yourself or you find yourself. In any vocation, everybody wants to be at the top. So how can I get to the pinnacle, the top of my profession? And that's what we are discussing. Now, if you are a Christian, if you are giving your life to Jesus Christ, if you have accepted Him as your personal Lord and Savior, I want to thank God for your life. If at the point in time, you have confessed Jesus Christ as Lord, you have told Jesus that I was a sinner before, now I don't want to be a sinner again. You died for me. I want to come to accept that offer you have given me because it's by grace. It's by mercy. And you have taken that opportunity and you have given your life to Him and now you are redeemed. Now you are a Christian, now you are born again. Then God had prepared opportunities for you to be promoted. But we have a protocol to attain this promotion. We have protocol to attain this position. According to the definition of promotion, the action of raising someone to a higher position or rank, or the fact of being so raised, which means, by this definition, you cannot promote yourself. A person cannot promote himself or herself. Because to promote means to raise to a higher rank. Somebody has to raise you. So if in the spiritual realm you want to be raised, Jesus laid down protocol to attain that. If in your office you want to be promoted, they have laid down rules on how to attain promotion. And that's what we are discussing today. So which means that this series of message or messages could be applied in the physical realm as much as you can apply this in the spiritual realm. Amen.
Amen.
So don't say, oh, this is only for church people. No, it's for all of us. All of us that are here today. So, even though you cannot promote yourself, this message is going to teach us how we can position ourselves for promotion. Amen.
Amen.
In your office, you can position yourself for promotion. In your profession, you can position yourself for promotion by following the protocol for promotion laid down by our Lord Jesus Christ. So this sermon is to prepare you on how to do this, how to position yourself. So if you have not listened to part one, you can do that. And I want you to follow us on this series. You're going to enjoy it. This series is going to take you to so many, many, many opportunities. And if you can desire to apply this into your life, you will have testimonies. Amen.
Amen.
You will do what? May you be promoted in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Every shackles of life, every gate of hell that we say you will not be promoted, the Lord will defeat for you in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Your promotion will come.
Amen.
Your greatness will come.
Amen.
Your blessings will arrive.
Amen.
Your children will be promoted.
Amen.
You will be great in life.
Amen.
Our church shall be stars.
Amen.
They will rule their peers.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
So in this series, we'll be discussing so many very basic things. So many basic things on greatness, on promotion, on service, on servanthood. As they are ordinate together. So, various tests that you must pass to be promoted will be discussed in this series. Promotion means that more will be committed to our trust. You know what it means? That more will be committed to our trust. So, the power of the tower is an access to promotion. So when I say the power of the tower, Jesus Christ, when he was finally going, demonstrated in that John chapter 13 on how to attain promotion, or how to attain to the greatness in the ministry, in the calling, in the promotion that we find ourselves. And what did he do? That's why I titled this, the power of the tower. What did he do? Jesus washed the feet of his disciples. This was explained in detail in part one. Jesus Christ humbled himself. It takes humility to do what Jesus did. It takes humility for anyone to do what Jesus Christ did to, a savior. The master, to begin to wash the feet of his disciples. But Jesus Christ was doing this to teach us that the way up is from the ground down. That to be the above, you have to learn to be beneath. To be the master, you have to learn to be the servant. And that's what Jesus Christ taught us in this place. 1 Peter chapter 5 verse 6. 1 Peter 5 verse 6. It reads, therefore, humble yourselves under the mighty hand of God, that he may exalt you in due time. The power of the tower means you humble yourself. The power of the tower means you are ready to do the little so that you can be trusted with the big. Then you humble yourself so that God can do what? Exalt you. Luke 14 verse 11. For whoever exalts himself will be what? Humbled. And he who humbles himself will be exalted. You want to be promoted? You got to humble yourself. You got to have the spirit of servant. You got to serve. Stewardship. Promotion does not come just because you want it or because you need it. But it comes because you have fulfilled the criteria for promotion. You can't just walk to your boss and say, I want to be promoted. You got to follow the protocol. You got to fulfill all the criteria. You got to pass all the tests. You know, in school, you don't advance to next grade until you have passed the test at this grade. Thank God we have some professors in the house. There is no professor that will pass anyone who did not pass the test. Because what is going to happen? If you are lifted up to the next level without passing the test at this level, at the first level, you become dangerous. Amen?
Amen.
You become what?
Dangerous
to yourself and dangerous to others. If you pass somebody who did not pass and you move that person to the next grade, it's going to contaminate that grade. It's going to pull them back. So in the same token, God will require you to prove yourself at one level before you are released to go to the next.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Illustration. You know, the cars that we drive, or all those equipment that we use, they have been subjected to serious tests to ensure that it is safe before they begin to sell them. If you fail to subject them to serious tests before you begin to sell them to people, then you're going to acquire liability, serious one, on the company. And the company can close down because of that. God will test you before he releases you to the next level. Every level of promotion comes with its own measure of authority, influence, and responsibility. That's what we're talking about. And test is not pleasant at all. Now let us see, in this part two, I want to explain to us the difference between test and then temptation. Several times, people think when they are being tested is temptation, or when they are being tempted is test. I want us to clarify this very well in this series. I promise you, you're going to enjoy this. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You're going to do what?
Enjoy.
You're going to visit this series and listen over and over again. I can promise you that. Because I'm going to discuss so many, many materials that will be useful forever for you, and of course for our children. What is a test? A test is not the same as temptation. Just get that from me. A test is not what?
A
It's not the same as temptation. They are not the same. Test is designed to encourage you to demonstrate your strength. Test is designed to encourage you to demonstrate what you have known. To demonstrate your strength, how much you have known. That is why at the end of the test, what will professor, what are they going to do? They will grade. You have A, you have B, you have C, and then you have F. Come back again. You did not pass. Which means what you know is not enough to pass that grade. A test is not designed to teach you anything. You believe that? You don't learn anything from text. The lesson has been taught before. So the professor is just testing what you have known from what he taught you before. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 So the text is designed for you to demonstrate what you have learned. Deuteronomy 8 verse 2. Deuteronomy chapter 8 verse 2. And you shall remember that the Lord your God led you all the way these 40 years in the wilderness to humble you and test you. It was a test for this Israelite to be led for 40 years to know what was in your heart, to know what you have learned. Hallelujah. Are you getting me now? 40 years it took them to be led to know what they have learned, whether you will keep his commandments or not. Before I will promote you to the promised land, I will pass you through tests. Maybe you will, when you get to the promised land, keep my commandments. Test is to encourage you to know, to demonstrate the strength of what you have known from what you are taught. So temptation. What is temptation? Why is temptation? Temptation is designed to entice you to demonstrate your weakness. To do what? Temptation is to entice you to demonstrate your weakness. You see the difference? Notice that both of them only bring out what is already in you. So temptation is to know what the kind of weakness in you. And that's why God will not tempt anybody. James 1 from verse 13. James chapter 1 from verse 13. Let no one say when he is tempted, I am tempted by God. For God cannot be tempted by evil, nor does he himself tempt anyone. But each one is tempted when he is drawn away by his own desires and enticed what he had in his heart. Then, when desire has been conceived, it gives birth to sin. And sin, when it is full grown, brings forth death. So, tests are from God and temptations are from the devil. God does not tempt us. Because temptation is to test or entice you and see what is the kind of weakness that you have. However, the tempter wants you to fail. He's looking for that faint possibility that you will slip up just so he can prove you are not the big person they tell you are. You're not a big thing. I can bring you down. That's what the tempter is looking for. I can bring down your family through this weakness. I can bring down your kingdom through this weakness. If you claim to be strong, if you claim very strong and a strong man, no, you can take me. Now the devil is sent out to prove that you are weak and you are not strong. Amen?
Amen.
If you say, I'm very patient, I'm a patient person, the devil will try to prove that you are impatient. You find a way to prove that you are impatient. But God can use temptation to be a test for you. So you can kill a stone with two birds. Kill two birds and with one stone. So God can use temptation as a test. The very same incident that the devil set up to tempt you, God can use it to test you. Amen?
Amen.
God does not play ashy for you. He doesn't. But there are those times that he will not shield you from ashy. He will not shield you from storm. He wants to pass through storm. But when you pass through storm successfully, promotion will arrive. Amen.
Amen.
There is no one who will be promoted without being tested. Do you get it now? Before you can be promoted, you got to be tested. If you don't want to be tested, it means you don't want promotion. How many of us want promotion? Beware, okay. test is coming. Test is coming. Test is coming. You want promotion? Amen.
Amen.
You see, when you fail a test, what happened? They actually don't agree the grade. That is why you see some things happening to some people over and over again. Over and over again. They begin to say, ah, is this person not a Christian? He has not passed. Until you pass, this incident will continue to happen over and over again. Over and over again. Until you pass the class. So, you see, test is not as important as what test we do in your life. Test itself is not as important as what test we do in your life. It is the outcome that is important. Look for the outcome. So don't say, God, don't let me pass through storm. Storm is not as important as what the storm is going to bring out in your life. So if you focus on what you become, then you'll be able to endure the storm when storm comes. Of course, a very good example of that is in Matthew chapter 7, verse 24 to 27. That would say the storm came, the wind blew, everything happened, but then we see the result. The one that is on solid foundation was standing. The one that is on standing soil collapsed. So if you can stand on Christ, you will be able to achieve anything that God desires you to achieve. Amen.
Amen.
So tests are supposed to make you a better person. They are supposed to become your stepping stone to promotion. James chapter 1 from verse 2 to 4. I will soon finish this. You know, I just want to give you as much as possible. Please take notice of all this. You can apply this even to our children. If you allow your children to run away from all the tests in the beginning, all the storm, all the challenges, they will come back in the future to blame you. They will come back to blame you. Because when you rise to a certain level in life, there is no more room for any mistakes. No more room for mistakes. Some things you have to know now, know them now. When you become the boss, no more room for mistakes. Anything that the little person can do, they can overlook it. Okay, let it go. But when you are the boss, you make that same mistake. You will pay dearly for it. You will pay dearly for it. That is why it's very important for us to take notice of some things right now. Don't push them forward. James 1, 2 to 4, my brethren, count it all joy when you fall into various trials, knowing that the testing of your faith produces patience. But let patience have its perfect work, that you may be perfect and complete, lacking nothing. Lacking what?
Nothing.
That is the cause. So, there are certain basic truths about tests that we want to discuss. And this is going to take us so far. That's why this is going to go to many parts, this series. The first is, you have to pass the test of faithfulness. Certain basic truths. For tests, first thing you have to pass in the issue of tests is faithfulness. Faithfulness is so important in all that we do. Faithfulness. Before God can promote you, before you can be promoted in your office, they want to make sure that you are faithful. Sometimes your boss will come when unannounced, when you don't even know your boss is coming. You just appear to see what is happening, what you are doing. They are trying to test you for faithfulness. If somebody is not faithful in a little thing, you make that person to be a boss of greater thing, it's going to fail. If you don't pass in a little thing, you cannot pass in a greater thing. Take it to everywhere. The scripture cannot be broken. The test of faithfulness is very important in promotion. You need to be faithful. And that's all God is looking for. Faithfulness. Luke chapter 16, verse 10 to 12. Luke 16. He who is faithful in what is least is faithful also in much. And he who is unjust in what is least is unjust also in much. Therefore, if you have not been faithful in the unrighteous mammon, who will commit to your trust the true riches? And if you have not been faithful in what is another man's, who will give you what is your own? If someone is not faithful in a little assignment, he cannot be faithful in a bigger assignment. Take it anywhere. It's going to fail. Nobody is going to promote you in your office. How many of us want promotion in our office? Be faithful. Don't cut corners. If they ask you to spend 6 hours, don't find a way of spending 3 hours. Don't sleep on the duty. unfaithful, how much more? If a man is unfaithful to his wife, or a wife is unfaithful to her husband, case closed. It will take the grace of God to bring things back to normal. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
I say the test of faithfulness is so important in all that we do, even with God. Proverbs chapter 20 by verse 6. Proverbs 20 verse 6. Most men will proclaim each his own goodness, but who can find a faithful man? It's very scarce today to find faithful people. It's not easy today to find faithful people. Employers are looking for faithful people. When they get one, they can give any price for that one. They won't let that one go. No, they won't let that one go. I am telling you, you are faithful. You are not complaining. They get you any time. Listen to me, I have applied this into my life. You want to beat anybody in the office? Just be faithful. Many people are not ready to be faithful. They don't want to work, they want the money. But you are ready to work. Don't even put in extra time to show that you love the place. You think they will let you go? No. If they let anybody go, they want to retain you. Because they want to make you as a what? Good example unto others. Faithful people have many scars. Honest people are not many. Check it out. It's improving. 1 Timothy chapter 1 verse 12. 1 Timothy 1 verse 12. Okay, before that, let's see Psalm 21 verse 1. Psalm 21 verse 1. It says, help more, for the godly man ceases, for the faithful disappear from among the sons of men. Sons of men, but it's sons of man. America, we call it men. Hello? I'm trying to make it, maybe they will listen to this. They will not know what I'm talking about. Men, man, men. So no more plural for men. They make it easy. Men, men, men. If you're talking about man, it's men. Talking about men, it's men. So faithful people are not many. That's where I'm going. So let's start Psalm 1 Timothy 1:12. And I thank Christ Jesus our Lord who has enabled me because he counted me faithful, putting me into the ministry. Until you are counted faithful, God will not put you in any ministry. Take it out. Go and give it to anybody. The scripture cannot be broken. The office will not make you a manager if you are not faithful. Cut it out. If you are not dependable, nobody. You get to be the most valuable person in the office. Somebody was talking to me one time. He was with Ducky Dollars. The man is not a big boss in the office. He said, "Man, you know how to make it in those where you work?" He said, "You have to be the most valuable person in the office." He said, when he was working with Ducky Dollars, he said, if they want just one person to work, they want to call him. So, you know why they do that? I said, why? Say, I can make coffee, I can make donuts, I can be the cashier, I can be everything. Say, there are people, they can only be the cashier, they cannot make donuts, they cannot make coffee. So, when they are looking for just two people, they call that one who can do the whole thing. Yeah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because that person has made himself the most valuable. So, we say, it's not in my description of God. You have to come and audit me. As long as you are paying me the same money, tell me to sleep. I'm going to sleep for you. Where the problem will come is, you tell me if you sleep, Emmanuel, if you are going to sleep, we're going to give you the money for somebody who sleeps. That is when I can come to the office and say, hey, I got bills to pay. My bills keep rising. It doesn't come down. You can help me to have more money. You are not happy when you cut short this money. But you are paying me if I'm a pilot. You pay me for as a pilot, and you are now telling me to be hostess. Of course, just pay the money. I don't say that is too low to me. That is very low. You ask me to go and find documents. Oh God, you to go and find documents. You make yourself to be the most valuable. That's where you can be promoted. The same thing with the Lord. You make yourself most valuable. You position yourself to be faithful, and then God will promote you at the right time. Amen.
Amen.
Am I talking to somebody here today?
Yes, sir.
Children, are you listening to me?
Yes, sir.
Make yourself to be the most valuable. And I tell you, you can break any stone, and no one will be able to stand against you. Amen.
Amen.
And God does not want people when they are what disciple is taking from discipline. Some people are not disciplined. When you call time, they don't come. I have a boss in my office. He's allergic to lateness. He's what? He will tell all of you. I don't want people to come late. When you come late, you can stop the meeting because of that. Begin to talk to me and you are like a child. You hate yourself. Next time you come meeting, you don't want to come late. Because they have seen that when people come to meeting late, it shows that they have no interest. It shows that they are not dependable. It shows that they are not serious minded. It shows that they are not organized. Why should you come late to a meeting? The meeting, you know, in this country, before they have a meeting, they will email you, they will do this, they will give you time, they will say, check it, accept the email. If you don't have the time, tell them why. They can, because of you, move the meeting to an appropriate time. Then after they have done all that, they say 10 a.m. It is 10 a.m. you're going to McDonald's and say, I have not taken my breakfast. Who cares? You cannot take your breakfast before the meeting. When it is 10 a.m., you are right there and it's helping me. In fact, before 10 a.m., I'm sitting down there. They don't query you that. Why are you sitting down 10 minutes of the time of the meeting? Sit down there, they love it. Do something else. But when it is 10, you are there. God is looking for people like that to bless. The Lord bless in Jesus' name.
Yeah.
We gotta put this into our life. We gotta have this lifestyle so that we can attain promotion. Because see, let me tell you something. It's more easier to be promoted than to sustain the promotion. Sustainability is the most difficult challenge for everybody. You want to be a rich person? Do you know what it means to attain riches? It's so hard to sustain yourself on that level. Because you don't want to be rich yesterday and be poor today. It's a very bad issue. That's not your portion in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Sustainability. It is, and if you're not disciplined, you cannot sustain yourself. I'm telling you. Because I tell you, hard time will come. Storm will blow. Wind will blow. But when you have attained that strength, you will do what? You will stand when others are falling. 2 Timothy 2:2. And these things, 2 Timothy 2:2, and these things that you have heard from me among many witnesses, commit to faithful men who will be able to teach others also. You cannot commit anything to people that are not faithful. They will mess it up. They will not even teach anybody when they are not able to talk themselves. 1 Corinthians 4:2. Moreover, it is required in stewards that one be found faithful. You got to be found faithful. Proverbs 25:13. A faithful messenger refreshes the soul of his masters. If you are faithful, your master will like to. I mean, we like to talk to you. We like to ask for your advice. We like to discuss matters, things that are important with you. Your master will like to even go out for dinner with you. Go out for lunch with you. Hello?
Hi.
And then you become so, you become jealous. Start of jealous. People will be so jealous of you. People will envy you. They say, the boss likes him. The boss likes her. The boss will not like somebody that is lazy. Somebody that will put him to trouble. You know, sometimes when you mess up, it could affect your boss. When they fire you, they do what? They fire your boss. Because they say your boss does not do what? Supervise you very well. So when you are the kind of person that they don't have to supervise all the time, that you are faithful, and it's easy, when he has to do this, you do it, people beyond expectation, your boss will like you. Will like to come to work to you. We're going to continue in this series. And we're going to talk so many things. Time will fail me to give all these points, but one very important thing that I want us to understand is that God is requiring that one of the tests we have to pass to be promoted is the test of faithfulness. Let me go through these points and then we're going to pray. There is no neutral position. If you are not faithful, you are unjust. What did I say?
If you are not faithful, you are unjust.
That is why they don't want to give people second chance. Especially in developed country. If they have false impression on you that you are wayward, that you cut corners, you work very hard to convince them that you have changed. But don't believe you can change overnight. So there's no neutral position. It's either you are faithful or you are unjust. Listen to me, a low energy level indicates a lack of passion. When you have a low energy level, you don't have energy. Have you listened to what is going on in politics in America? You see Donald Trump. When he says he will divide you, these people, he will quickly divide. He said you are a low level energy. He will continue to say he's a low level energy. He's a low level energy. He's a low level. And then your date will fall down. Before you know, you will drop out. You will drop out. You will continue to have a low level. You don't have energy. Oh, you don't have energy. He can't have energy. He doesn't have energy. And he will divide you and you are gone. For you to come back, it's going to be hard because you believe what he's saying. So a low energy level person indicates lack of passion. It means you don't love the job. You are just coming for certain things, certain other reasons. You don't have passion for it. A tendency to complain about other people or things indicates a critical negative spirit. When they see that you always complain in the office, you complain in the office, it means you are not faithful. It's a kind of spirit that is a negative spirit. It doesn't help the organization. If possible, they will do what? Get rid of you. Hello?
Hi.
Am I saying something? I have just a few more and then we pray. A tendency to make excuses or not accept responsibility. What does it mean? It means an unteachable spirit. It means that it's not teachable. You are telling your boss, correcting your boss all the time. Your boss knows that, well, I can't work with this one. This one cannot be my vice president. Because it's going to give me a hard time. It's unteachable spirit. Complaining, making excuses, you don't accept responsibility. You be like, hey, we have to do this way, not that way. That's the way you say, if you continue to do that, it means you are not teachable. And then it means you are not faithful. Listen, people who make excuses never excel. People that make excuses never cannot be promoted. They never excel. Go and write it down somewhere. It's been proven. I'm telling you the statistics. It's been proven. They are typically non-achievers. They are immature people. They shift blame. It's a sign of immaturity. Complaining and making excuses. Not trying to accept responsibility. A sloppy appearance or poor hygiene is also another indication. An inconsistent lifestyle is another indication. People who don't pay attention is another indication. If you cannot notice small things, there is a problem. And there's a tendency that you cannot exert because God will notice things before you can make corrections. Amen?
Amen.
A tendency to gossip, either giving or receiving. What are all these little things important? They are very, very important. Let me close with this one. All these things that I'm saying on the part of the tower is to help us. It's never too late for anybody. God can change any life. God can change any situation. But the only way God can do that is to know your position. I don't know your position. I cannot talk for you. I cannot speak for you. You know where you are standing, you know your weakness, you know your strength. What God wants from everybody is to do what? Change. When you desire to change, God will allow change to come into your life. If you are not a Christian, you are not born again, you are still alive, God can change you and you become born again. There is a power of change in the blood of Jesus Christ. If these are not normal as it's supposed to be, God can bring change. When God brings change, promotion we call. God does not appear without blessings. He comes in with blessings and is ready to bless each and every one of us. So, this message, don't say, oh, pastor is talking about me, he's speaking about me, maybe my boss in the office called pastor before. Next time, I will not ask for a recommendation from pastor. I will not ask, because when I ask the recommendation, it means that maybe they call my pastor and it's not their friends, he's not talking about me. No! Everything I'm saying is for you, it's also for me. Some of these I've applied into my personal life. It works for me. It works for me. I'm not bragging, my brother. I'm not bragging. It works for me. I try as much as possible in my secular work, not to joke with my work, because I want to pay my bills. If for no reason, that's a good reason. I want to do what? I want to pay my bills. I got people in my office. When I get to the office like 7 a.m, I will meet them there. If I come very early, I'm supposed to start work 8 times. Sometimes I come early. If I come 8 o'clock, I'll meet them there. They ask me, I said, when do you start work? When do you work? He said, I always start 6:30. 6:30, don't you sleep? These people will start, there are about three of them. But one is very, very positive. These people will start 6:30 and they will cross 4:30. He said, Emmanuel, I love this job. He said, if possible, I want to sleep here. I was talking to my wife, I think it was this morning or yesterday morning. I said, some people, they are so grateful for what they have. This man is always grateful. He will laugh. He will go around and say, oh, I love this place. He will laugh. He will go around and walk around. He's telling me, I'm telling, people don't have secrets in this country. As he's telling me, people are hearing. And they are telling everybody, you know that man? He said, you like this place. Dondo, you know what is going on? Mr. A said, you can sleep here. Hey, Janet, have you had? What? He said. So, they will take it to the boss. And the boss will say, oh, this is the kind of person we want here. The same thing for somebody who is complaining. I don't even know what is going on here. This mayor, I don't understand. This governor is like this. If I'm this president, you don't know. If I'm this one, you don't know. And they will take it, they will take that rumor. They will say, ah, he said he's going to kill the president. He didn't say that. You know when they take, have you noticed something? When they take negative rumor, they have to eat. When they take positive rumor, they reduce from it. Haven't you noticed that? They always act because they want to take more trouble for you. Praise the Lord. So, that is why you must be careful what comes out of your mouth. There's power of life and death in this tone. If you want your boss to first get you out, it's supposed to be last in, last out. You shouldn't be first in, last out, right? You shouldn't be first in, last out. But if you come in last, if you're not careful, you'll be the first to go out because of why you say things. So these things I'm telling us works. I mean, these things run rather work. So apply them into your life. It will bring changes into your family, bring changes into your ministry, bring changes into your business, bring changes in all your life and videos. The Lord bless you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let's bless worship the Lord because I'm so good. In power of the tower, you want us, Lord Jesus, to try as much as possible to humble ourselves so that you can promote us. To be able to accept all things and be faithful. So that even the little thing you have given us will be faithful, so you can commit to us greater things. So that you don't want to start from the greater, but want to start from the little, and so that you can promote us to the greater thing. Help us, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
The word that came to us, help us to apply it into our lives in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Thank you, precious Holy Spirit. Blessed be you forever. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying.
Amen.
Amen.